Good morning, everyone. In this video, we will start our new chapter, chapter number 10. This one is the video for class 6th computers. And here we go, starting up the next and the last chapter of computers for this year's syllabus. The name of chapter number 10 is Internet Online Surfing. That means in this chapter, we will be thoroughly discussing what could be the things we can explore using internet. Let's start the chapter. The one that you can see in this blue box, online surfing. When we are first starting the chapter, my very first duty is to let you know what exactly online surfing means, what exactly this online surfing actually stands for. So this online surfing actually means using internet, looking at different things or exploring them. Didn't understood? Not to worry. Online surfing can be simplified in the words like exploring the internet or looking around different things that you can do using internet facility. Therefore, coming back to the chapter name itself, it can be understood that using internet or exploring internet is all about to be done in this chapter. Here we start with the introduction itself. Read it along with me. Internet is an important medium for sending and receiving the messages, information, etc. That means internet is an important tool. It is actually an important tool which allows us to send and receive messages, information, data, etc. We all are doing this in our everyday life. Here comes the second point. It is a network that connects society together. Using internet, people can connect out with other people. Like I am right now talking to you. I am right now communicating to you, not directly, but communicating with my own words. You are watching this video. It is just a mode of connection. Same way, using internet, one can connect to another person. When many people does this together, when many people do this together, they form up a society. So we can simply say that internet is a network that connect people across the globe. That connect people across the globe. Or in other words, you can say it connects society together. This was all about the introduction of the chapter. Internet is an important medium for sending, receiving your data, messages, informations. That can be in the form of like files, audios, videos, etc. Email is the last chapter we have read. Chapter number 9. Hope you remember a bit. In the same way, we can even use internet for other facilities, for other services. Second one was it connects the society together. That means using internet, one or more than one people can connect again with another side, one or more than one. That simply means either can there be one-to-one communication or either can be one-to-more communication. Now here comes up the next heading. As per given in your book, the next topic for discussion would be commerce. First of all, question arises, what is commerce all about? So commerce is actually an activity of buying and selling products and services between people. It simply means when you bought something, that can be any product, that can be any item, or at the same time, it can be any service also. So you are the part of commerce. You had done commerce. Commerce is associated with trading. Commerce is associated with trading. In commerce, only one thing is supposed to be understood, that is, commerce is nothing but an activity of buying and selling products as well as services between people. Products as well as services between people. Example, you went to a shop to bought something. You paid amount of money to shopkeeper and bought that particular item to your home. Here, in this example, there is no use of internet, mobile phone, tablets, or any other sort of electronic medium. So what you have done? You have done commerce. I repeat my example. You went to a shop to bought an item. In return, you have given an amount of money to shopkeeper. In this particular example, there is no use of computer, tablet, or not any other sort of electronic device. Therefore, what you have done commerce. So commerce is nothing but simply an activity of buying and selling products as well as services. This was all about commerce we have learned. Let's move up to the next one. Now we would be learning what are different sort of the people, those who are involved in commerce. Students, there are three sort of people who are directly involved in commerce. First one is producer. Second is seller. And the third is buyers. One by one, we will be learning it together. First one, producer. Made of produce. The one that produces any product, any service, or any item. That means producer is a person, or can be more than one person at the same time. Those who produces various items, products, as well as services. Talking about now seller. Seller is the second person who is directly involved. Once you are doing commerce, seller is the second person who is directly involved. He is the one who sells items, products, and services to you. And next and the last comes the buyers. The one who pays for purchasing those items, goods, services, etc. Now let's learn an example. The example that is given in your book, a farmer who is growing crops. He is a producer. He produced those crops, those vegetables, those veggies. Later on, he sold it to a particular person. Let it be a shopkeeper around our street, no? Let it be that person. Producer was the farmer. Now the shopkeeper is having that veggies, those vegetables, who is having street, our street itself, no, a local shopkeeper is having. He is selling those vegetables to us. So here, shopkeeper is the seller, and us, that means we, the one who purchase those vegetables, will be the buyers. I repeat, three people are involved in commerce: producer, seller, buyer. Producers are those who used to produce items or services. The one who is producing it. Take another example. Let's talk about Maggie. It's a product. The company who is producing it is a producer. The company who is itself making it is a producer. The local shopkeepers around our house, those who used to sold us those packets of Maggie, they are the sellers. And if you are going to buy it, in that case, you will be the buyer. Every time now you are watching here, services are written. Providing services, various items, providing services again and again. There would be a question, what are services? So services are various sort of the particular facilities you are getting, such as like education. It's a service. Hospitality. The one you are getting in restaurants and hotels. That is hospitality. Health services. Transport services. Communication services. These days you are buying data packs. That is, you are paying for service, internet service. So that is, either you are getting the item, the product, or you are getting the service. Therefore, the one who produces is producer. The one who sells it to us is seller. And we, if we are buying that, will be the buyers. Now let's come up to the next topic, which is e-commerce. We just learned a moment back about commerce. Let's revise that once again. It is an activity of buying and selling products and services between people. There is no use of internet, neither mobile phone nor laptops. No, not at any cost you will be using any electronic medium. In simple commerce, only commerce is written. That means no electronic medium is involved. Now let's talk about e-commerce. E in this e-commerce stands for electronic. Okay, so therefore e-commerce means electronic commerce. It is also known as electronic marketing. What is it also known as? Electronic marketing. In this, first of all, let's read out this, what is written in the slide. Read with me the second point. It consists of buying and selling goods and services over an electronic system such as internet. That means in e-commerce also, we are doing the same thing. Buying and selling goods and services, but one more thing is involved, and that is electronic system. Electronic systems such as internet, mobile phones, laptops, personal computers, desktops, etc. are basically involved. Now, e-commerce, third point I'm reading, have a look. E-commerce is the purchasing, selling, and exchanging of goods and services over computer network or internet, through which transaction or terms of sale are performed electronically. Pay attention towards this last point. E-commerce is actually purchasing. That means simply purchasing is done. Selling, either you can be the seller, the one who sells product, item, services. Or the third one is exchanging. I repeat, e-commerce is purchasing, selling, as well as exchanging goods and services. But all these three, that means purchasing, selling, and exchanging, are done over computer network or internet connection only. All right. Whether you are purchasing, selling, or exchanging any goods or service, everything like this is done over internet only. Whatever sort of transactions you are doing, whatever sort of terms of sales existed, everything is performed electronically. Let's jump up to another example for this. You are shopping. You are doing this online shopping thing, no? You are doing online shopping using Flipkart. There you are checking the quality of the item. What are the various details of the product? What is the seller particular words? What are the words of seller? Like he would be saying about the product that there are only 14 days written policy. Sort of the conditions will be there. So those are the terms of sales. What are they? They are the terms of sale. Talking about the transaction now. You paid him the money using your credit card, debit cards, net banking, etc. So you have done transactions. You would be paying your fee online. So that is another type of the transaction your parents are doing in that way. Transactions are nothing but giving and taking. Okay, the things that are basically exchanged over electronic mediums are basically termed as transactions. So in under this e-commerce, whether you are exchanging, whether you are purchasing, or the third one, whether you are selling any goods, products, services, items, etc. First thing, it will be done using internet connection or computer network. Second thing, whatever transactions, whatever terms of sales there existed will be also performed only electronically. There will be not any use of, there will be always use of computer or these sort of electronic medium. In e-commerce, there is no use of any other sort of the particular mediums. If you are talking electronic medium, there will be use, but it cannot be done like you are going there. Somewhere like Flipkart office exists, you stand there and then taken up the product. No, e-commerce doesn't involve such sort of practices. It only involves the use of electronic mediums. In commerce, I repeat, in commerce, there is no use of mobile phones, internet, etc. But in e-commerce, there is use of mobile phones, internet, computers, etc. All right, students. So in this video, we had learned till here only. Your work is to keep reading the particular parts and revise it till we drop up the next video. Thank you.